Ladies and gentlemen, Street Talking Other Stuff with Mike Mad Dog Magnotti. Thanks for tuning in today. It's nice to have you here. Hey, it's January. Come on, let's have a good time. Let's get through this cold weather and spring will be here sooner or later. Dear God in heaven, let it be sooner. But hey, you know, it's interesting. I had a lot of snow over the weekend, but I watched the weather reports this morning on Dan Kuntz's show. We're supposed to warm up. Maybe it'll all just melt and go away. But look. Exit laughing. I'm sorry. I just was speechless for a moment about how well this play is doing. Now, I've been talking about this for a while. This is a comedy I directed that is the Music Theater of Wenatchee's winter show. We have one weekend left, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Now, folks, I am not overselling this show. People are wiping tears from their eyes in the first act from laughing so hard. Everyone is loving it. A little old woman in a German accent came up to me and said, "Thank you so much for bringing the show." Well, it wasn't German. to Wenatchee, but look, www.numericapack.org. There's still good tickets left. We've got three shows left, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I know I'm nagging you, but you don't want to miss this. This is funny. People are thanking us for bringing it, saying, "Hey, I really need laughs this winter." So, okay, a little bit more about that later, but you know, just a couple of things. In this middle of this political season, we need to remember that political speeches have a lot to do, or a lot similarity to steer horns. A point here, a point there, and a lot of bull in between. And did you hear what happened when Bill Clinton won the presidency years ago? And this is a story a lot of people don't know. When he was elected president, he called up his mom and said, "Mom, hey, I won the election." And she said, "Honestly?" And he said, "Mom, what difference does it make how I did it?" And you know why each state has two senators? So they can take turns being their designated drivers. Okay, so Street Talking Other Stuff, Mike Mad Dog Magnotti, I got a really cool guest for you today. We're gonna have a lot of fun. But hey, you stick around, we will be right back.
Hey folks, Carrie from Blueberry Hills. A chill is in the air and it's a perfect time for some old-fashioned comfort food like our amazing Eggs Benedict, chicken fried steak, French dips, soups made from scratch, or fruit pies fresh from the oven. The crowds might be gone, but we're still here for you folks. So bring an appetite and a friend to Blueberry Hills in Manson, where you pick, you sit, you eat, and you visit. Open Wednesday through Sunday from 8 to 3, wildaboutberries.com.
Dick's Heating and Air Conditioning has been proudly serving the Wenatchee Valley for over 35 years. And just as Dick's has been there for you, they have also been an essential part of our community, supporting local youth sports all year long and your Wenatchee Wild.
Thanks for your support.
Thanks, Dick's Heating and Air Conditioning, for all your support.
Thank you.
Dick's Heating and Air Conditioning, your local, independent, trained comfort specialists. Call 884-6444 today.
Hi, I'm Jim Heinlein, independent agent and owner at Springwater Insurance Group here in North Central Washington. And one of the things we enjoy doing is teaching people how to find the right Part D drug plan. And you know, if you went into a shoe shop and they just sat you down and handed you a pair of shoes, that'd be confusing. You'd want them to measure. But we take a measurement at Springwater Insurance Group. We ask you four questions. What's the name, the dose, the frequency, and the pharmacy for your medications? This allows us to measure and get the right fit for 2020. Give us a call at Springwater Insurance Group for the right fit for your drug plan at 888-2600.
At Harvest Valley Pest Control, we know you are committed to making your home and business a healthy and pest-free place. Hi, I'm David. Give us a call and we'll give you a firm price over the phone and schedule a time that works for you. We will do an in-depth 30-point healthy home or business inspection and craft a customized plan of action designed specifically for your pest issue. Give us a call or visit our website today.
Talking other stuff. I am really happy to introduce to you Mr. Blake McCormick. Blake, nice to have you
here. How's it going, Mad Dog? Glad to be here.
Good, cool. You know, it's interesting that this gentleman, we're going to talk about his business today, but that's not really the primary reason I had him on, though it is very interesting. Now, I'm going to tell you how I first saw this guy. I went to see Music Theater of Wenatchee's last year's Apple Blossom Show, Newsies, right? Yep. And I pride myself on an eye for talent. And I was thinking about the show that I've talked about. I think you've heard me talk about it, Exit Laughing.
Yeah.
But I was looking to, I like to seek out people to ask to you know, to audition, and I saw this guy up on stage, and I said, wow, that guy's got something. So I called Blake, and I said, hey, would you like to try out? He said, no, you know.
I did.
Actually, I'm thankful now because Matthew Pippin's playing the role and doing a great job.
Know, yeah.
But that's how I first noticed you. I said, because I didn't know him, didn't know anything about him. So I actually sent him a Facebook message request and saying, hey, you know, I saw you.
And I got this message from a Mad Dog, and I was, at first, I received it, and I did not reply.
I think I looked at it,
and you were probably like, oh, he looked at this a week ago and never responded, but I had to get some more information on you.
Well, tell me how the other information came about, if you remember.
Okay. Say that again?
Tell me how you found out who I was.
Your daughter.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, who was a part of the show. Yeah. And I was like, yeah, so this random guy messaged me on Facebook. And does anybody have, he says he's a director in town. I was like, is this like some alias or something? Like, is he trying to meet up with me? And like, I don't know.
He's one of these stalkers on the internet.
Yeah, you know? I was real nervous, yeah. But... And it was ironic that I actually was talking to your daughter, and she's like, yeah, he is, you know, he is crazy, but we love him.
He said this guy named Mad Dog texted me and asked me to try out for his show, and my daughter goes, oh my gosh, that's my father.
Yeah. and she was like, yeah, it's, you know, the show is, you had seen me in Newsies, which yeah, I first yeah. initially come out with my shirt off, so I assumed you mostly
That wasn't what it was.
I assume you just mostly
I mean, he's cute, but he's not my type, okay? You know?
So we had a good laugh.
But no, I mean, it's just, I could tell. I mean, you had a good stage presence, okay? And I don't really remember a whole lot about your part. But I said, wow, this guy's dynamic. He's got a good stage presence. He'd be somebody I'd like to have audition for, you know, this part in...
Yeah, and I definitely considered. I was, you know, I was in the process. We just, my wife and I just got married this last year.
You've been married a year.
Yep, 1 year, December 8th. Right. Thank you. And so Newsies was a huge show. I mean, we, especially being one of the Newsies, we were just constantly on stage. Yeah. So that just meant lots of rehearsal time, and being our first 4 months of being married, it was a lot to, you know, to commit to that. Yeah. So next show... My wife and I would love to do something together.
That'd be cool. Yeah. Right, no kids yet then, huh?
No kids yet.
Yeah, because that's something I have to be careful of. Because when I first started with music theater back in the early 80s, or the mid 80s, before you were born, probably.
Yep, 92.
I'm just thankful to be alive. But, you know, I mean, I really loved acting, like performing. And I was doing it too much. And my wife finally said, look, you need to... you know, tone it down a little bit. Now I go to her and I say, hey, the show's coming up. I'd like to try out for it. Should I? She says, yeah. And I said, are you going to complain? She goes, yeah.
Probably
you should try out for it. Anyway.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's addicting. It's so much fun. You are constantly getting to express and, you know, have your creative outlet, which I definitely need. And I've had my whole life. I've always done some form of theater, acting.
Yeah, well tell us about that a little bit, because your mom is big in the theater community here in town, too.
Yeah, so she started out doing shows when I was a kid at our church and before she ever dreamed of having her own theater company. Yeah. And so I grew up doing, the church shows and things. And in elementary school, about fifth and sixth grade, I had done, I was Rooster in Annie.
Really?
Yep, and I was, we also did a musical called Honk, which is a modern day telling of The Ugly Duckling. Mm-hmm. And both shows were super fun. Definitely, it was like, all right, I love this. I love being a part of these shows. You just get so bonded with
It's really cool.
The cast and
the relationship building is really good. And that's one thing I love about music theater. It's such a great organization. The people. I mean, we're like family, you know, so.
Yeah, and so I did that growing up, and then that was actually the point at which, so I went to middle school, and I went to the same middle school and high school all the way throughout. It was a private school in California, and I did shows starting in seventh grade, and I did seventh, eighth, ninth, all the way through 12th grade. I actually did two shows my junior and senior year, loved it. I got to be Jesus in Godspell.
Oh, really? I played Jesus.
Are you serious?
Well, the church I used to go to did original shows, which I helped write the script. But I played Judas for a long time.
Okay. Jesus is a much better role than having to play Judas.
But my character more was fitting for Judas. But then the guy who played Jesus quit. He got weirded out or something. So they needed the only guy who could act, which was me.
So you got to put on the sandals and the free hugs shirt and got to be Jesus.
But I played Jesus different because I laughed and I, you know, cracked jokes and interacted with people. I wasn't the serious.
You're probably like the real Jesus. Probably a lot more like him.
Probably a lot more like the real Jesus.
Yeah, you probably look a lot more like him and everything.
Yeah. I hear he was strikingly handsome.
I believe it.
Okay, now your mom, she's head of stage kids here. She started that a while back.
Yes, so she started actually in California. We are, if you notice the hat there. I know.
I told him he could wear the Winer's hat.
I almost didn't wear it because I was like, people are just going to see it and they're going to bounce. They're never going to want to watch this show again. So I didn't want to leave that mark on you. But it's part of my story. It's part of, you know, San Francisco is where I grew up.
Okay, right.
And
we forgive you, Blake.
Thank you. Thank you for still having me, not forcing me to reveal my hat hair underneath. So she started Stage Kids California and ran that for 3 or 4 years while we were living there. And I mean, California in theater and kids theater, it's very established. There's a lot of outlets, a lot of opportunities for youth theater. And so it was pretty competitive, and kind of her angle, her desire was always to have an affordable option for kids that might not otherwise be able to, because some of those programs were, expensive.
Yeah.
And so she started that there and then brought it up when my family moved up and they've been in the Valley for 6 or 7 years now.
Yeah, well, I was on the music theater board when she first came and made the presentation that she was going to start something.
Okay.
Like that. I remember talking about it. So yeah, it's cool.
So you're the reason that she has.
I just kind of sat there and listened. I'm a terrible.
You're just giving the thumbs up.
I'm a terrible board member. Anytime I've served on a board, I've looked for a way to get off as soon as possible. Okay, musicals or straight plays? Which do you like better?
Musicals. Yeah. I've always been a musical guy. I think the reason is, I haven't done any plays. I've strictly been in musicals every year. But that was all because of sports. I really wanted to play sports as well, I was the Troy Bolton, you know. That was actually at the same time when there was High School Musical had come out, and I was playing the theater and the sports world. And I had the nice swoopy hair that I flicked across like that.
He was one of those guys.
Yeah, I was very much one of those California guys. So.
But you ought to, I'm a drama guy. Really am. I directed Streetcar Named Desire a few years ago, and that's the type of play I love. Problematic family relationships, that type of thing. And actually, for me to be directing Exit Laughing now is a departure because I've never directed a comedy before. Mm-hmm. I can direct one, let me tell you. But the next play I want to do is a little bit more serious. It's called Doubt. I don't know if you ever heard of it. Meryl Streep and Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Okay.
It's about a nun who runs a Catholic school, and the parish priest is suspected of being inappropriate with one of the students. Very tense, very good, a very small cast.
Yeah.
But that's what I would like to do next after my wife gets over theater widow. For a while,
yeah.
So.
You gotta give it a little time and then drop.
Okay. Okay, well, hey, look. The reason I had you here, though, was to talk about that, all right? But the other thing is this. You've got a local business here in town, which is kind of interesting. So we had lunch a while back, so we talked about this, and I said, wow, this kind of stuff is kind of cool, all right? So talk about the background of the business and that type of thing. Let's start getting into that before we take a break, and then we'll get into more detail when we come back.
Okay, I mean, first of all, I have to clarify, it's not my business, so I need to come on here. My business, but I work for an awesome company.
You can say my business.
I can say my business.
You can say anything you want, because nobody watches this show anyway. And I tell
that's
people
the
this,
key.
What if I don't know the answer to the question? I said, well, just make something up.
Yeah. So yes, anyways, my business, Web Guides Marketing, is extremely successful. We are having a lot of fun. It's a great business. It's called Web Guides Marketing, and it started as a strictly marketing company.
Right.
And it was just two guys that were co-owners and hired me on as their first employee.
Okay, when you say marketing company, you're going to be a company that marketed other people's products.
Correct. Okay. All right. Yeah. So, and we did some business consulting and SEO, search engine optimization, and Google AdWording, and that type of stuff.
Oh yeah, I don't understand every word. Let's talk about Bitcoin because I really understand.
Oh gosh. No, so it was very a lot of stuff that I didn't know about. I actually went to Bible college.
Yeah.
So to
too.
Be doing marketing was maybe marketing in a different way, but but very different.
You're a business evangelist.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, but we're going to get into the products that he's here to talk about today, which are not similar at all, but really unique. But hey, we're going to take a break, but street talking other stuff. I'm talking with Mr. Blake McCormick today. Appreciate you being here, but you stick around. We will be right back.
It's estimated that one-third of Americans do not have a financial plan. At D.A. Davidson, their advisors are working to change that because they understand the importance of planning for the future. At D.A. Davidson, they believe in partnering together to build a strategy tailored to your needs. They spend the time and have the knowledge to help keep your financial future on track. Let D.A. Davidson Financial Advisors of Wenatchee put the strength of advice to work for you.
Hi there. It's Les Schwab Tires. Well, more like Les Schwab Alignment and Brakes and Shocks and Wheels and Tires. Now, some tire places don't offer all that. They only sell tires. And we're not sure how they sleep at night, because all those services affect things like steering and stopping. That's why we offer more than tires to help keep you safe. Stop by or book an appointment at LesSchwab.com. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
AC Checker has new owners who put customer service first. When you have to get there on time, call fast, friendly, reliable AC Checker, 663-TAXI. AC Checker has the industry's only on-time or it's free guarantee. Conditions apply. Call AC Checker, 663-TAXI to schedule your cab or schedule online at acchecker.com. Call American Classic Taxi, 663-TAXI. That's 663-8294.
Mary Maids of Wenatchee believes a clean home is a happy home. Mary Maids provides holiday cleaning services to cheer about. Don't let the seasonal cleaning ruin the festive fun. Mary Maids can simplify your life at a great value. It's never too soon to start planning a holiday perfect home. Mary Maids of Wenatchee happily offers a worry-free guarantee. Locally owned and operated, let Mary Maids do the cleaning while you focus on your family and friends. Call Mary Maids today.
Street talking other stuff. We're black. No, we're not black. We're Caucasians.
We're Blake.
Yeah, we're Blake. Blake.
Okay, to that.
Let's start all over. Street talking other stuff. Mike Maddog Magnotti. I'm here with Mr. Blake McCormick, a young entrepreneur. And the company's name again was?
Web Guides Marketing.
Okay. What are you marketing? Okay. Tell us about the products.
Sure. So I have a couple here, actually. This is a gift. Can I give you your gifts that I brought for you?
Yes, I always like presents.
All right. Do you grill at all?
I am the cook at home.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Well, then why don't you try that on? This is a man apron.
And this is great. Okay? Because, you know, when people come into my kitchen and say, what can I do to help? I say, you can get out of my kitchen.
Yeah, there you go. Now you don't have to say it. You can just point at your chest and they'll know what they need to do. So we sell man aprons.
Oh, cool. All right.
Hey, that's a better response than I get from most people. Just look at me and laugh.
No, so, it's cool. I mean, man needs an apron if he cooks.
Man needs an apron. So we kind of, as I told you before, we were doing business consulting.
Sure.
And one of our main clients was doing e-commerce. So everything they did was sold online. And we realized, like, we can't really consult somebody in something that we're not doing. And so we were like, let's pick a product. And this was actually the year right before I got hired on. And this was Jordan and Scott, and they're both partial owners of the company. And they were like, so they just took down a list, 5-10 different items. There's, I don't know, coffee beans and fun hats and different things. And one of them they saw a market for was aprons, and man aprons, because there's so many women's aprons out there, but not a huge market for the man aprons. And so they started with 12 designs, I think it was. And the first year we sold maybe 1,000, yeah. not even. But they, I mean, just kept picking up, and we saw on Amazon, on our website, and on Etsy, and within, I mean, we're now three and a half years in,
okay.
and this year? This year we sold almost 30,000 aprons.
Yep. My stock in your company?
Yeah. I mean, that's what I'm asking. I'm working as far as I was like, can I get some stock in the company? So we're, I mean, it's going great. And so that's just one of the products that we do.
Right.
So the other that we do here.
See, man, this kills me. Look at this other product that they do here.
So most people look at this and they're like, I have no idea what that is. But this is actually a jump
rope. If I was Italian, I'd say, is that a Garrett? You know, just
no, not quite. This is the world's fastest speed rope,
really?
I will have you know.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
And not your typical beaded playground rope.
Yeah.
But you probably can't see, but this guy, I mean, it's got a zero.
Yeah, he's spinning that there, and it's going to keep spinning till the end of the show.
It'll probably go, yeah. It'll probably honestly go for the end of the show.
It's incredible how fast it's going and long, so.
And these get picked up. This is actually our top selling product.
Okay.
It's called the Bullet Comp. We also sell a Surge, which was our top selling rope for a long time. But the market just becomes, I mean, it's really the CrossFit community has changed our business.
Okay.
So many, you know, we have three different tiers. We have our teams. So there are actually jump rope teams. Did you know that?
I have seen some of their demonstrations on YouTube once
in
a while.
Okay.
So.
And they'll do parades and, you know, you'll see them at the New Year's parades and they'll do with light up ropes or different things. But there are full on competitions and full jump rope teams. And I actually had the opportunity to go to Nationals last year, which was held at Disney World. And I got to be our vendor there to the Jump Rope Nationals. And
really?
Most
really?
Of these kiddos are between the ages of like 10 and 18, and they are just hauling on these things. You know, they got the quick steps, they've got double unders where the rope actually goes under twice.
Yeah.
And they are incredible.
And are they using your jump ropes?
And they're using, I would say about 80% of the people out there are using our jump ropes.
Cool. And now this design is interesting here. I mean, I guess you can disconnect this and reconnect it or something?
Yeah, so the really cool thing about the Bullet Comp is that you don't need any extra hardware.
Okay.
Previously, you'd need a screw on the outside, and you kind of clamp it down on the wire,
right.
And that holds the handle in place.
Okay.
But now they're adjustable. You can just slide it right on, and then you tighten it down, and it cinches. It's got a little...
Oh, it does it all by itself.
Yep,
okay.
Cinches, and then sticks on there. So that's the nice thing, because then you don't have to carry an extra screwdriver to every time you want to adjust your rope.
Oh, yeah. That was, when I jump rope, that was a pain in the neck. Extra screwdrivers.
For all that.
All my pliers and my, you know... adjustable wrenches.
Totally. Yeah. So that's the jump rope world, and we have our teams, and then we market. We do kids ropes as well. So we have just the standard licorice and economy beaded ropes that we sell to schools.
Okay.
And then our other market is
licorice.
Gyms.
I don't know what's a licorice jump rope?
Sorry, it's called a licorice rope. It's basically like a PVC, like a plastic.
Okay.
So it's got a plastic handle and just a kind of. Almost like a rubbery, flimsy PVC.
Okay.
Yep. And so we've got our teams, our schools, and then our gyms and our CrossFit.
Yeah.
So those are kind of our three target markets.
Okay. So these CrossFit evidently encourages people to use jump ropes in working out and that type of stuff.
Yeah. They call them WODs. It's workout of the day.
Okay.
And in almost all of their WODs, they have some form of jump rope because it's just a high intensity, high endurance.
Sure.
But you only have to jump rope for 15 minutes, they say, and it burns as many calories as running for a half hour. It's like twice as much as running, and I think four times as much as biking.
Really? Okay.
Calories wise.
Well, people, you know, you ever watch boxing? You've seen boxers use jump ropes all the time. You've seen the Rocky movies, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I would have kicked them off the show if you hadn't seen the Rocky movies. Cool. All right. But it's just the interesting mix, jump ropes and aprons.
Yep.
You know, so.
It is a strange combo. And so the way we actually got into the jump ropes is. So Matt, he is now the third business owner. He was one of our consultants.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were working with him very closely. Our aprons were starting to do better. His jump ropes, he's actually been established for almost 20 years.
Right.
He started selling speed ropes back when jump rope teams were just getting established and started. And so he's been in the game for a really long time. You can tell by our website because it's byjumpropes.net. What kind of dates us?
Okay, when you say by, is it B-U-Y or B-Y?
B-U-Y, yep, okay. byjumpropes.net. Yep. And
again, if you can't find this stuff later on, you can always email me, maddog@nwi.net, and I can fill you in on how to connect with Blake and this company and this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But that's interesting, and you're loving it, obviously.
Oh, I'm loving it, yeah. Yeah. And we're getting into new realms of the company, too. We just purchased a $25,000 machine that engraves on the handles, which is super fun because we'll be able to, one of my jobs that's kind of transitioning this year is going to be a little bit more on the sales end of things. And so one of my marketing strategies is going to be finding these guys' logos, just put them on a handle and send one to them. Be like, the other one? Oh, come on to our website. And they've got a personalized for their gym speed handles. And that's invaluable. I mean, for a lot of people, this customized world is just super exciting because it's something that Amazon can't do. You know, they can't customize, they can't do custom products. Mm-hmm. They just sell, you know, whatever one-offs that they can. And so it's something that differentiates us from a lot of other companies.
All right, cool. All right, well, I'm talking with Mr. Blake McCormick, okay? I like to have interesting people here. This one was really good. I love it. I'm going to wear this in the kitchen.
All right.
Anybody walks in, there you go.
Okay. I want to see a picture of that. You can tag us on Instagram.
I will do that. But anyway, we're going to come back, talk a little bit, say goodbye to Blake. I'm going to push Exit Laughing again. You know, of course, come on.
I'm going. Come on Friday, and you can, I'd love to meet you as
All right,
well.
Cool. All right.
We'll be hanging out.
Talking other stuff. You stick around. We will be right back.
With TV advertising, what we want to do is more deeply connect with the community.
People spot me in different parts around North Central, you know, Costco and Wenatchee, say, hey, you're the pizza guy. And so they wouldn't know that if it weren't for the TV commercials we've done.
We've been here so long that people already know who we are and what we do, but to have that image flash on their television screen as opposed to just hearing in the radio or seeing in the newspaper. I just love the fact that we can actually put our finger on when a customer comes in and says, I saw your ad.
It's becoming increasingly difficult in this digital age to know where are your customers listening or watching, because I watch all the different channels that they watch too, like Cooking Channel, History Channel, and so it was wonderful to be able to be on there.
I would say that if you want to do business in Wenatchee, then you should connect with the people of Wenatchee, and there's no better way to do that than with NCWLIFE.
I'm Jake Carpenter, Vice President of Investor Relations for Equilis Group Incorporated and Equilis Capital Partners. We deliver solutions to challenges like how to use your retirement accounts to safely access income-producing real estate to avoid market risk, and how to defer capital gains tax without using a 1031 exchange. Discover your real estate and investment potential at Equilis. Call me today at 509-460-8700.
What is it to be a volunteer firefighter? Is it the gear, the training, the vehicles you learn to drive, the honor of protecting your community? Time, energy, sweat, sometimes blood and even tears. Every call may not be a victory. Sometimes you'll walk away wondering if you helped at all. But sometimes you will be a hero.
Street talking other stuff. Talking with Mr. Blake McCormick. Now, again, what's the website where people can go to?
So this guy here is apronmen.com.
Apronmen.com.
Yep. Apronmen.com. Okay. And then buyjumpropes.net. Okay.
But they can also go to Amazon. They'd probably rather if they went to your website than Amazon.
Yeah, support local business. Okay.
All right, but look, I'm going to push it again, okay? Look, Exit Laughing, it's a great show. And I don't know, my doggone Magnotti, why do you keep nagging us about this? You'll love it. You should go. www.americapack.org or maddog@nwi.net. I'll tell you how to get tickets. But hey, Blake, thank you for being here, buddy.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it. Okay,
thanks for having me. I opened up this so I could be more like you.
All right, cool. All right. Okay, you have a great day. We will see you next week. Bye-bye.
Oh, that was a terrible throw.